the reason why we were so afraid is quite apparent. As we witness the
destruction. Once again, hello everybody. Welcome to November. So nice to have you here. Title of my talk today: Sit in Your Unlimited Power. Course in Miracles talks about the power that we have as holy children of God. And it talks about it in a very profound way. What it tells us is that we have all the power in the universe. Our power is unlimited. And there is no power outside of us, and there is no power that we do not have access to. And we do not have to wait to have access to it. We have access to it right now. We have all power. And I find that Course in Miracles students tend to read these words and kind of glaze over and not really take them in. So I'm going to invite you to just take it in for the 20 minutes or so of my talk today. Just sit in your unlimited power for these 20-25 minutes and just feel it and claim it. Okay, Course in Miracles says, "You who perceive yourself as weak and frail, with futile hopes and devastated dreams, born but to die, to weep and suffer pain, hear this. All power is given you in earth and heaven. There is nothing that you cannot do." So some people think we got to wait to heaven to get to heaven to feel this power. But this is very clear that all power is given us here on earth and, of course, in heaven, but here on earth as it is in heaven, as the Lord's Prayer says. So it's not a symbolic metaphor. It's a practical, clear teaching. So we need to let go of that conversation that says, well, not now, or this is just a symbolic metaphor, or I'm not there yet. You know, just set all of those thoughts aside, put them up on the proverbial shelf, as they say. There's a good metaphor. That's a real metaphor. Put them on the shelf. Put all those objections on the shelf and sit in your unlimited power. And when the Course says you can heal all things, it means all things. It means world hunger. We're healing it. War. We're healing it. Sickness, we're healing it. The separation between the vaccinated and the unvaccinated, we're healing it. We're going to sit in that power and heal all of those things right now because we can and we're guided to. And it's happening now. Course in Miracles says, be not content with future happiness. It has no meaning. And it is not your just reward, for you have cause for freedom now. You know, this idea that it's going to be some future time when we're going to feel this power is just insanity. It doesn't make any sense because there is no future. Come on, that's intuitively obvious. It's always just the present moment. The future is always this nebulous thing that just a moving target. We're never there. It is never the future. It is always just now, and we have cause for freedom now. And we have to free ourselves from all the limiting thoughts and world beliefs. I was confronted this week again about, you know, beliefs about aging. You know, we have to, like, confront those and let those go. I got this belief that as this number increases, this number that the world calls your age, that you have declining mentality and that, you know, a mental acuity, and you have declining physical ability. Let that idea go. That idea is insane. You know, yesterday I did 200 sit-ups while holding 16 pounds of weight at my head. You know, just going up, holding an extra set. I did 200. And, you know, that's really, really pretty good. I'm very happy about that. Yeah, I mean, I remember during the Las Vegas conference, and I was up on stage with Reverend Roxy, and I did 30 push-ups. I can't quite do 30 push-ups anymore. I'm working back up to it. I did 27 the other day. So I'm a 30 perfect guy push-ups with a straight back all the way down to the floor and all the way back up. And in Las Vegas, I was in my underwear in front of 400 people. You know, the reason why I did those gets a little lost, but it was that whole talk was about challenging our image of the body and the limitations that we think the body has, and just to let go of them and to demonstrate something else to ourselves. So I'm not limited by this number. That is my age. I'm not limited by this year that people keep asking me when I was born, including, you know, a lot of government things. You always have to like write the year of birth down. There is no limitation about those things unless we embrace it and decide that it's true. So sit in your unlimited power right now with me and let go of all those things. Just let go of all those things. Those things aren't true. Okay, last week I gave a talk and I was talking about the transcendentalists, and I talked a little bit about Ralph Waldo Emerson. And Ralph Waldo Emerson has said something that he said that I really loved, and I want to repeat it again. So Ralph Waldo Emerson said, "To laugh often and much, to win the respect of intelligent people and the affection of children, to leave the world a better place, to know even one life has breathed easier because you have lived, this is to have succeeded." So I had an experience this week that reminded me of this phrase. And it reminded me of the phrase that said, to win the respect of intelligent people. So this week, I had to write an article, which was basically an obituary for Judy Scutch Whitson, who was the president and a key figure in A Course in Miracles community. I'm sure most of you know who she is, because she made a transition. And I knew, I had gotten the guidance that this was going to be a challenging thing, that I was really the one person that could really write something comprehensive, because I've been, you know, connected to this movement for a really long time, and I know Judy Scutch and have met her on numerous occasions, and, you know, I've been right at the heart of all the controversies, but right at the heart of all the achievements, and that I had written a really good obit for Ken Wapnick when he passed, and that I was going to write a really wonderful obit and article about Judy Scutch Whitson. But it would be a little bit of a challenge. So for 2 weeks, I kept, when I thought about it, just offered it up to the Holy Spirit. I wasn't worried about it, but I would have thoughts like, you know, this is going to be a challenging thing, and I would just offer it up to the Holy Spirit. And then last Sunday night, it was the time to do it. And I just sat down. It took 3 hours, and I did it. And I knew that when I did it, that it was really, really good. It was a really good thing. And I read it over a number of times, and I thought, wow, Holy Spirit through me did a really good job with this. But then later in the week, I think around Wednesday or Thursday, I got a wonderful message from A Course in Miracles scholar, Robert Perry, who really praised me on the article I wrote about Judy Scutch Whitson. And when he did, you know, Robert Perry is a highly respected A Course in Miracles scholar, and people, you know, think of him as a very intelligent person. And I remembered this passage that we had from Ralph Waldo Emerson that said, to win the respect of intelligent people. And I go, wow, I focused in on that last week, and here is the praise and respect coming from somebody that's really well thought of and highly regarded for his intelligence and scholarship in the A Course in Miracles community. And I just took it in, and I loved it. I loved it. And I've talked about it a little bit, and, you know, some people might think I'm bragging or that my ego is involved here. You know, we had a minister years ago, Reverend Tom Marcoux, and he said something once, and he goes, if you were a circus performer, after you do something wonderful, you like stand out there and put your arms out and you say, ta-da! And you let everybody, you know, applaud you. And that's a good thing. And, you know, I think it's actually a characteristic of being able to claim and sit in your power is to sometimes say, ta-da! I mean, to say it to yourself and to say it to other people maybe as well. But in our striving to be so politically correct all the time, people are really afraid to do it anymore. But, you know, it's actually a really good thing every once in a while to just, you know, claim and embrace your accomplishments, to say, ta-da! You know, Robert Perry, I'm not going to read what he wrote me, but it was really very nice. And he, you know, he said, you know, your article was very nicely done, very well done. And he said some other things. And it was really sweet to get that. And I really remembered that I had just been focusing on to win the respect of intelligent people. It was a manifestation of that. You know, see, what we focus on manifests. And Holy Spirit, I've been turning it over for 2 weeks, and Holy Spirit and I, you know, together wrote a really wonderful article about Judy Scutch Whitson. I believe it was respectful. I believe it really honored her. But I also believe it was very truthful and honest about some of the controversial things that surrounded her life. And one thing this Course in Miracles community needs right now is truthfulness and honesty, because it was a little not great about that for a long time. So if you want to look at the article, it's on the CMC website now. So go ahead and look at it. I'm pretty proud of it. Okay. Course in Miracles says, "You who perceive yourself as weak and frail, with futile hopes and devastating dreams," I already read this once, "born but to die, to weep and suffer pain, hear this, all power is given you and earth and heaven. There is nothing you cannot do." It bears repeating. No matter what we got going on in our life, I mean, our dreams don't seem to be manifesting, we are sad, we have pain, we have physical problems, that's the way it is. But just remember, all power is given you in earth and heaven. And sit in that power multiple times every day. Don't despair because of your limitations. I say that a lot. It is your function to escape from them, not to be without them. Nobody here is to be without our limitations, but our limitations are ways that we can prove our power to ourselves. When we escape from those limitations, when I built myself back up to 200 sit-ups holding 16 pounds at my head, you know, when I escaped from the limitation about that, it's a great thing. And it was a great witness that I could have to myself. So there's a lot of things going on in the world right now that can be disturbing. Obviously, the pandemic is very disturbing. You know, for me, this controversy between the vaccinated and the unvaccinated is really disturbing. The mandates that come down that limit people who are choosing not to be vaccinated, I mean, they're very disturbing to me. But I turn it all over to the Holy Spirit, just like I turned over writing the Judy Scutch Whitson article, and I get thoughts to remember. Thoughts like, all things work together for good. There are no exceptions except in the ego's judgment. It's all working together for good. I may not be able to see it right from my point of view, from right where I am, but it's all working together for good. Course in Miracles also tells us a happy outcome to all things is sure. God's promises make no exceptions, and he guarantees that joy can be the final, that only joy can be the final outcome found for everything. So, it's all going to end with joy. It's all going to end happy. And we need to just be able to sit in the power of those statements in the midst of issues and challenges that we have, and know that we're here to heal those things, and then to offer that healing to our sisters, brothers, and others everywhere. And so it's a great thing that we're doing by sitting with those challenges while we sit in the midst of our power. And we have the freedom to do that now. And we can be free from those challenges now in our minds, and we can be sure that that freedom is going to manifest with the challenges themselves. Course in Miracles has an interesting passage where it says, not one seeming difficulty will melt away before you reach it. And I had some insight about that because it's my own experience. So, you know, it's talking about how once we've accepted the Holy Spirit's plan as the one thing that we would do, there'll be nothing else that the Holy Spirit will not arrange for us. Without our effort, he's going to go before us and he's going to clear the stones out of the path. So not one seeming difficulty will melt away before you reach it. But what I have seen is that sometimes you just really have to take the next step. And sometimes the difficulty and the stone still appears to be there. But if you're confident that you're following your guidance and that you're doing what Holy Spirit wants you to do, you're not going to trip on that stone. That stone is going to have an absolutely miraculous way of dissolving and getting moved, maybe just as your foot is going down on it. So you can't always wait for it to appear clear before you take the step forward. If you're really sitting in your unlimited power and you feel confident that the Holy Spirit is working through you and wants you to step forward, then you step forward in faith, even if that stone appears to be there. Because that seeming difficulty is going to melt away before you reach it. Maybe just as you're putting your foot down. And that is just the way I have seen it work time after time after time. And because I've seen it work so many times that way, I don't have the anxiety about certain things that I once had. And I don't need things to appear cleared up before I step forward. I can step forward in faith. You know, that meme, Freedom Now, is actually several times in A Course in Miracles. And here is another time. It says, should I wait in chains which have been severed for release when God is offering me freedom now? And this is that idea that we think we're in chains. And maybe we still see chains around our wrists or our ankles, metaphorically. But the truth is, those chains don't attach to anything. They're just chains that our mind has put there. Those chains have actually been severed. They've already been cut. You know, Jesus would say, by his life, those chains were cut. They're not there anymore. And we have to understand that and not think that those chains hold us back or prevent us from stepping forward. We can step forward because those chains have been cut and we have freedom now. But of course, we have to be able to sit in our unlimited power to do that. And we can heal everything. You know, so a couple of years ago, there was a wonderful documentary made in 2017. And I was not aware of it. I just saw it with Reverend Deuce Althea a few weeks ago. And the name of the documentary is called Heal. Just Heal. H-E-A-L. And it's very well made. And it's got a lot of really notable people in it. It's got Marianne Williamson is in it. Anita Morjani is in it. Deepak Chopra, Michael Beckwith, Joe Dispenza. It's about an hour and 45 minutes long. It's very thorough. And it's a really good overview of spiritual healing and how some people have used it very successfully. It's inspirational. But I had a problem with it. Okay, what I saw was the overriding idea was that spirituality and spiritual healing was a force that we could harness as a complementary force to address the issues of healing, physical healing that we have had in our lives. And the problem I had with that is that it made all the illnesses quite real. You know, it talked about the strength of spirituality and the power of spirituality to counteract these illnesses, but in that framework, the illnesses were still quite strong, and the illnesses were still something that we had a marshal all these energies and these powers in order to confront and maybe rise above. And, you know, that's a step. But I think A Course in Miracles wants us to take it a step further. It wants us to really sit in our unlimited power. And when we sit totally in unlimited power, we realize that all those things, all those problems, all those illnesses are just hallucinations in our mind. They actually have no power. They have no power at all. Spirituality is not a healing force that you use to counteract the destructive force of illness. A Course in Miracles, healing, miracles, spirituality, that's a power that we sit in that tells us that all those other things are just illusions with no power at all. And that we can just love ourselves, and we can love everybody, and we can love everything that's going on in the world, and we can love the vaccine mandates if we have to. Because they're all part of an illusory world that actually has no power. And if we sit in our power and we affirm that all things are working together for good and that a happy outcome for all things is sure, then that is indeed what will happen. And there's another Freedom Now quote from A Course in Miracles. That was the third one that I found. And it talks about being merciful to ourselves and being merciful to the world and being merciful to our sisters, brothers, and others. It says, be merciful today. The Son of God deserves your mercy. It is He who asks that you accept the way to freedom now. The Son of God is us. The Son of God, of course, is also all our sisters, brothers, and others. And they are all asking us to accept our freedom now, to sit in our unlimited power now, to understand that that is not only a totality of power, it is all power, and there is no other power, and there is no power in the illusions of sickness and death. When we sit in our total unlimited power, we recognize all those things as the hallucinations that they are. And we set up the energy that just allows those things to disappear. Sit in your unlimited power and be the Christ today, every day, as often as you can. That's my talk for today. Thank you very much.
The reason why we were so afraid is quite apparent. As we witness the destruction we have made, we're not to heaven.